Let's learn Bing Chat, which uses ChatGPT. Now, first question is, if there is already ChatGPT, why should I use Bing Chat? The reason is, Bing Chat gives you references. That means it doesn't just answer your questions, it tells you where it found the answers. So there is a lineage, there is a connect, there is a reference. Just go to bing.com/chat on any browser. On Android, you can use Microsoft Swift Key Beta. In Edge browser, you also have the Bing Discover button, which opens a separate pane on the right side. In all these cases, you need to log in using a Microsoft account. Let's start with a simple search. Depending on what you're doing, you can ask for a creative, balanced, or precise answer. I'm going to ask how many elements are there. I'm going to copy the same question and put it in Google search as well, because it's important to understand the difference. So first I'll do Google search, which gives me almost instantaneous results. And when I click here, notice the results are not coming quickly. It's thinking and thinking and thinking, and it takes inordinate amount of time. So what is the point? If I'm getting instant answers here, why would I have spent 10, 15 seconds getting the same answer? And that's the important thing you need to understand. It is not a substitute to quick search. So now let's ask another question. Now we know there are 112, but how are they classified, right? And most basic classification is metal, non-metal, metalloid. Okay, now let's try that here. Same thing. So it gives me a much better answer, and it is giving me multiple references which I can go to and look at in greater detail. In addition, it is even suggesting what else I should be thinking of or the most logical relevant questions I may have. So from that point of view, this is much better than Google. In case of Google, it did give me metal, non-metal, but not enough detail. And the site which has come up is definitely not the most authoritative site for understanding elements in the world. Now we are going to use the Bing Discover option, which is the same thing in a separate pane here. What I can do here is I can select. When I'm selecting the text, it gives me the option of sending the text to chat. And then it gives me many options. Do you want to summarize, expand, explain, or revise? I'll say explain. Not just rephrasing what was given as the input. It also looked at some additional references, and it is explaining that in a much better way. So this is just an Amazon site, but I'm going to go to insights. It looks at the site which is currently open and gives me some related videos. It also gives some additional information about the site, and it gives me analytics about the site, the ranking, and so on and so forth. So it's quite useful to get insights about what is currently being shown. Now, another thing where it really shines is compose, which is creative expression or writing. So let's say I want to write about dangers and benefits of AI, and I want it to be short and I want it to be professional. So quite a useful summary. And then you can copy paste it to wherever you want. Brand name for custom sports shoes. And here it's more of an ideas, and yes, it is a brand name. So amazing names it has given along with sort of a tagline. So I want to use this and say add to site, and it will add wherever my cursor is on the main page. So that, in a nutshell, is how you use Bing Chat to your advantage. Couple of things you should know where you should not use it for. Anything which requires expertise, professional knowledge, it's risky to use any kind of AI to advise you. So that's it for now. Thank you.